नमस्ते नेपाल, नमस्ते नेपाल। ओके ओके, आई बीन गिवन 20 मिनट्स, आई एम गोना इन्वेस्ट 1 मिनट एंड आई विल कीप 19 मिनट्स टू माई सेल्फ। सी, बींग ऑन टाइम इज अ वंडरफुल थिंग, यू अग्री? या सो आई जस्ट सोल्ड इंडिगो। ओके, सो वन रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल माई पियर पैनलिस्ट स्पीकर्स, स्पेंड द टाइम वेरी वाइजली बिकॉज देर आर पीपल हु ऑन अ पार्टी हार्ड। My friend who's recording, he's gonna party hard. He's had a birthday last evening. So let's say happy birthday to him. Awesome. Guys, you know, this is my second time. And I really thank Kavi that, you know, I made it back. And I'm very desi, right? So I don't like this sophistication. So can you all stand up, please? Awesome. I'm not going to make you dance. Just stand up. Okay. We are here to build next 5 awesome, fucking awesome unicorns, right? So I'm gonna say who's gonna build it, and you're gonna say we gonna build it. Who's gonna build it? Who's gonna build it, Nepal? Awesome, thank you. Okay. Wow. Okay, I'm not going to fall down. He's saying you'll fall down. Okay. These are the brands I got to work with. I got very fortunate. I'm very privileged to go through this journey, right? There are some brands which are number one in their category, which I have highlighted it on top. And there are some startups where I failed. And I embrace the failure. I'm very lucky that I failed. So there are two type of people, entrepreneurs like Kavi and a lot of these of my friends who got a lot of courage. And there are people like me who come from a very modest background, who started their journey with a 3,500 rupees salary. And so we work as an entrepreneurs, right? We build these brands and make fantastic money too. Today I'm gonna talk about experience economy, right? So before you actually, you know, look at the screen, let's get the basic fundamental thing very absolutely transparent and right. What all the things we buy? Do we buy product and services anymore? We buy experiences, right? It's about experiences. So pricing is not a differentiator now, right? So you selling a mobile for 10,000 rupees versus he's selling mobile for 10,000 rupees. How you choose brands? You choose brands based on the trust, affordability. Affordability? No, I'm tricking you. No affordability. Because it's parity, right? Is that quality? Is that service? Right? That's the experience you are. So MI. MI is a local brand? You have MI in Nepal? Yeah. How many Android users? Raise of hands. Yeah. So Southeast Asian countries have more Android users because we like quality, but we are very quality conscious, cost conscious also. So when brands build their product and services, what all they used to keep in mind 5 years back? Product, process, and people. So what has changed now with the new age companies? How many startups are there in this room? No startups. 1, 2. How many profitable startups are there? Difficult question. So investors, so my previous keynote speaker really focused on, you know, some of the tough questions she asked. And why she's asking those tough questions? Because it's about that perspective and profit. Previously, people were not really thinking about making a business. Entrepreneurship, CEO, being a CEO, co-founder, it's all flashy, right? But once you raise a round and you don't make money, you're spending 1,000 rupees acquiring the customer and you're only charging 500 rupees when there is no loyalty. that perspective of building a business is super critical. I've learned that in my, 20 years, what not to do more than what to do. So always keep that perspective of profit. Wow. So adding that profit, you add that value. So that value is something where the customer gonna pay, right? It's not about the product, it's not about the service, it's about the delight, right? That delight where you will keep giving him a smile and he will get the dollar out from his pocket and give it to you. And your job is to make sure that you retain him. You keep him on the same page, you keep selling, right? You don't let a setback makes you push back, right? Setbacks are part of the game. Some of the legends here said that setbacks are actually good things because you get up all over again. So I got some free time. So one more thing before the slide comes up, right? I'm a firm believer of design thinking. My second time here, anybody who heard me previously here? Lucky for you. Okay, so what is design thinking? You know, when it's very flashy term, a lot of people are making a lot of money. I'm one of them, but it's a very interesting term. And it's actually a process, it's actually a culture change. Design thinking is not only for designers, it's for everybody. All of us are very, very creative. All of us are very creative, right? We have that perspective. We just feel very courageous to come out and implement that. And design thinking tells us that, you just need to make sure that you keep customer in mind. Whatever you are making, whether you're in a call center, you're in a back office operation, you're in a sales, you're in a marketing, because you have your own KPIs, right? But a lot of people, the companies, the brands, they build awesome experiences by this. And again, if you take a decade back and if you just Google design thinking, you will not find this customer empathy. What is customer empathy? This is not. So customer empathy is actually about putting customer in the center, right? Like Mr. CEO of the biggest bank said, right? It's about making you retain, making you come back all over again and again, right? Crafting things for him. So whether you understand the market or not, whether you observe a lot of things or not, whether you define your processes right or not, whether you ideate with the right people or not, you prototype at a right stage or not. You A/B test with your own perception or a real market feedback or not. And you scale when the competition is pushing you or just like you get a lot of investment money. You don't keep the customer empathy out. Because if you keep that in mind, everything else will span out. Because it's all of us who will represent the customer within the company. If we all think that that is something which we can do, and we do that well, I'm telling you, you will create some awesome experiences. Because he's the guy who's not in those boardrooms, not in that office, who's paying that check. Your salary, my salary, as in company's overall fund. It's still not up. Guys, I'm not going to count this time, right? This is extra time. So guys, Nepal ecosystem is actually 5 years old, right? You've got a lot of traditional businesses, but the startup, the whole startup ecosystem, I think Kavi's venture is also 4-5 years. So have you heard, do you guys use Food Mario? How many of you use Food Mario? Just raise your hands. For others who have not, I hope the food is sponsored by them. So you better use it. So Food Mario, do you guys, so like my one of my friends said that they are, so social businesses, digital platforms are not something you should spend time on. But interestingly, he also said that you follow you on a lot of great celebrities on YouTube. You find that interesting? How many of you are 20 to 25? Less than 25, raise of hands. How many of you are 35 above? How many of you are like me, 19 twice? Again, I'll take a step back and say that it's about that perspective. Guys, I need the screen back. So why Nepal, having such a great talent, but still don't have a single unicorn? 5 years is good enough. Because when I said Food Mario, Rohit, right? So, yeah, he has done a fabulous job, right? Food Mario, home cooked food, right? He's creating a lot of entrepreneurship, logistics, right? The whole delivery thing, so job employment is there, right? He's making women earn a lot of money, while they are sitting at home and going through their hobby. So why everybody in this room is not actually giving them a chance? If they're not successful in Nepal, how will they come and go and win India? Right? How will they go and actually do awesome on Southeast Asia? And I'll take that example. So we all talk about MVPs. MVP, everybody understand? Minimum viable product is the most, it's like an abusive word in startup ecosystem, because most of the CEOs say, go with MVP. Let's go live. Because actually, but if you go to a restaurant and you don't like a food, will you go back again? So nobody gives a product second chance, right? So the whole philosophy of experience economy has made MVP disappear and shifted to MDE, minimum delightful experience. So Food Mario is actually creating experiences. 200 rupees, healthy, affordable, hygienic food. That's awesome. You know, so cheers for Food Mario. It's one of your... So whenever you craft any startup, any idea or any business, it has to have a functionality, it has to have a reliability, it has to be usable, and it has to be delightful. What is the local cab aggregator name? Sarathi? Sarathi. So what they have done it right? So are they MVP or they are in MDE? How many of you use that app? You all like to drive cars, so one car, one passenger on the road. You like it, right? It makes us feel good. Use them. Give them a chance, right? And they fall under this. So I have not used them. I've read a lot of reviews about them. So booking a ride is actually comes under functionality, right? But if something goes wrong, if you charge extra, get in touch with customer care and getting the money back is actually reliability, right? App works on a 2G network is actually a great usability. And despite a great service, they are giving you discount offers also, is actually delightful tennis, right? So once you measure your own product, measure it in this grid. Companies for future, companies for next 10 years, the unicorns in this room will happen on MDE and not on MVP. Again, very basic, fundamental, core thing. I say this as a, this is a spark plug of a car. Spark plug is the cheapest part in the car, but that's most important. Maybe it's 100 rupee, but without that, the car will not start. Right. So at the heart of your brand is user experience. Then it's a customer experience. So you buying on, so which is the e-commerce site here, local? Do you have Amazon? No. Which one you said? Okay. So when you buy on that website, and the buying process is easy, is user experience, right? When they deliver it on the time, it's customer experience. Once you don't like it, and they give you a 30-day return, hassle-free return, is actually a great brand experience, right? Great brands build on that trust, right? Times to come, when we are especially crafting for millennials like you, you're millennials, right? Young guys. It's very important. It's very, very important to have understand this. So make sure from the MVP and MDE, when you do this, you keep the key parameters in these circles and you know what you are tracking, what you are going after. And it's in this order: user experience, customer experience, and brand experience. And let me sell Indigo. So we have three core promises: on time, hassle-free, and affordable fares. So that comes in the two: user experience and customer experience. But having a great network is something which is a brand experience. Making you fly from A to B on time 95% is that brand experience. And that's why Indigo has 47% market share of India. Big businesses, small businesses, and startups. Many times, have you used Orkut? We talked about Facebook and MySpace, but have you used Orkut? Anybody here use Orkut? Right? So when Orkut was there, they had everybody hooked onto it. But suddenly Facebook came and they were nowhere. Right? Because they didn't accept the change. They didn't accept that they need to add more delight to it. Right? So businesses, how many of you use Yahoo Mail? First email ID is a Yahoo Mail. How many are still using it? How many have you have a Gmail ID as a main primary ID? Just look back, everybody. So businesses needs to understand that BAU, let's say that you are a SME offering a product on various e-commerce, right? That's your business as usual. But tomorrow, you are too dependent on that e-commerce. Tomorrow, there is a problem of policies in countries like ours, right? In India, we have it, and in Nepal, you have it. So let's say that the government says, and there is a policy change, and that e-commerce company where you are making your bread will not exist. So if you only have a BAU, you're gone. What's more important? You have your own identity. You have your own digital platform. How many businesses have their own platform here? Website, app. Again, I think most of us are. So most of you are actually working for brands, right? How many of your brands have invested and they keep having in-house teams for their platforms? Again, very few. So most of the brands in India are facing this problem. And we are going through a lot of transformation. So despite Indigo had 32% market share, and previously I worked for Quikr, they established these practices in-house. And they got very, very good returns. It's called iterative transformation. Because disruptive transformation is a very, very misused term again in the ecosystem. You have to continuously iterating. Continuously go back, try something, fail. You know, out of 10, maybe 5 things will work out. And then there is thing come, which is innovation. Right? So Google Maps, was it an iterative transformation or an innovation? It was an innovation. Do you agree? You all use Google Maps? Defining the canvas. So do you know that most of the brands, startups, when they fail, they don't have these things figured out. Most of you will say that, hey, I have a great platform, I have a great AI engine, I have a great 3D modeling algo. can I find a customer? And you go and talk to investors, hey, can you fund me? But you forget that what is the core problem you are solving? Right? Are you solving for Nepal? Are you solving for India? Are you going to solve it for Southeast Asia? At least have that vision. Whom you are solving for? Are you solving for millennials? Are you solving for working class? Are you solving for travelers? Whom you are solving? Are you solving for housewife? And you can have a multiple personas, right? If you don't have these four things, whom, why, where, and what stages, you will not be able to scale. You may be able to raise pre-series A, you'll be a bootstrap company, but you will struggle to scale. You may raise series A, but you will not get profitable, and again, you will fail. And I failed many times. This is not something which you find in books, right? You'll find a lot of gyan, but this is absolutely on your face. I'm telling you, figure these out. Two approaches, always. Reactive versus proactive. So I checked into this great hotel yesterday, and I reached early. I have a habit of, you know, fashionably early. Indigo. So reactive. I reached early. They said, hey, boss, it's 10:30. Our standard. Sorry, Kavi. Where is Kavi? Anyways. So Kavi is not here. I can see. So standard checkout time is 2 p.m. I said, boss, you can't do this to me. I've hopped in 3 flights. So I flew from Kochi to Goa, Goa to Delhi, Delhi to here, just to meet you awesome guys, right? So they said it's 2. Then I requested. They said, okay, we'll do it at 12. Then I got my card out and I gave it to them, right? And they made me checked out at 10:45. But imagine that if a normal guy who doesn't have the card, so what they have done? They have done a reactive way, right? It's reactive. I pushed and they have done it. What is a proactive way? They given me a room which was empty, right? Nobody was staying there. They did not kick somebody out that, hey, you go out, he is come, he will stay. So if they said this, hey boss, you are early, right? And we see that this is the second time you are staying with us. And last time you requested for a higher floor, when we're giving you a higher floor and we are making you check early. Isn't that a delightful experience? Wouldn't that you come back again? And I'm not bashing anybody, and they've done something very right. So my friend, we celebrated his birthday, so they called him at 12. They said, sir, it's birthday, and we cut the cake. That's awesome. And he will remember that moment. It's about that moment. If you buy a shirt which you don't like, you can return it, but you can't minus the experience of this event from your life. You're vested. So always, always be humble, be grounded, be proactive. Your most unhappy customer, is your biggest asset, because he is not happy. He is giving you feedback. He is giving you that time. You better make up for it. You better hear him. You are not investing anything. And he is giving you opportunity that you will improve. And he's got a good expectation. That means he's got some expectation from you, despite you have not done something right. So always have a proactive approach. Now the fun part. Guys, once I have 4 minutes left, just do this. And minus those hours, you know, time which is not utilized. Netflix. How many Amazon Prime or Netflix users, subscribers? See, sir, a lot of social time. Sir, a lot of. So what is Netflix? What is Amazon Prime? A platform. Content in somebody else, which was there. So they made the whole platform, the whole business case from user empowerment. What they have done, user empowerment. So you watch the movie you want to at the time of your choice, the place of your choice on your personalized device. They made your mobile a home theater. That's so awesome. No ads, right? All the OTT platforms, they have done it awesome. So what problem they have solved? And so people like us, we have seen the digital cassette age and then the DVD days, right? So we used to find that which is the physical library we can get a porn movie from. All decent people. But, you know, they solved this. So they made a setback, work in their favor, and made a business model out of it. Now they are launching their own private labels. Uber, the Kali Pili taxi, existed, which is a famous taxi app. By the name, aap to pata yaar, you know. So in India, we had Kali Pili taxis existed. And even here, do you now take local taxis? But you have your local taxi, right? They are doing the Uber job. And Uber will come into this market because this is too good a market to leave. So it's about, again, user empowerment. You see the fare first. You agree to it. You choose the cab you want. Hatchback, sedan, SUV. You want a carpool. Again, they build. So it's not about full-length albums, right? They said, boss, out of that album, this is a song you want. And you don't need to buy everything. Amazon. So it's not that shopkeepers are not there. Retail businesses are not there. So it's about variety and endless. So when you look at any business, any area, you think that boss, it's already been done. It's been done by 10 people. Why should I do it? It's not about the idea. It's never about the idea. It's about your passion, which sir said. It's about the dedication. And it's about you to make it work better. If you have the skin in the vein, right? If you're desperate to do it, you will do it. If you don't have a fallback mechanism, you will do it. You will figure it out. And Amazon has done does just right. They said that if they are promising something to get delivered at 9 p.m., it's your girlfriend's birthday, and you don't want to, you know, miss that. So if you want that assurance, you better buy from Amazon and not from anybody else. So Flipkart actually existed in India 5 years ahead of Amazon. And today, Amazon have a neck-to-neck competition. So when I don't want to miss my wife's, you know, and I don't want to get beaten up, I order from Amazon. Airbnb. We are talking about experiences. It's homestay. It's your house. He's coming. And Airbnb is making money. It's his service. He are taking travelers on his Jeep to that expedition. They are the travelers. But they are making money. Similar thing for TripAdvisor or Expedia for that matter. They're selling our flights, but charging you the processing fee. So what next? These guys have done it. So should we say, ha, these guys have done it and we should work for them? No, right? We have to do something. So your local language. Are you proud of speaking your local language? Yes. Nepalese, right? Right? How many businesses have the digital identity in local language? I'm not asking, I'm just telling you. Andar dekho, you will know it. So yesterday, I met a very bright girl. She was asking that she's a blogger, right? But she don't believe in content. And she wants to now learn digital marketing. I said, what will you do with digital marketing? She said that she will get traffic. I said, get traffic for your blog. So you have to believe, right? Content is king. I'm telling you, content is king. For future businesses, if you are not investing in content today, UGC, reviews, ratings, I'm telling you, somebody else will come and own the customer and you will not own the customer. Because he's going to judge your businesses on that other platform and take a call whether to buy or not buy. This is 28% as we speak. In 3 years' time, this is going to be 80%. And I'm telling you, voice is gonna be big. We still have people in tier two, tier three towns where they can't read and write good English. But everybody can speak. That's so natural. So mobile, you have to speak in your local language and the result should come. I'm telling you, anybody who will work on this will get great market in Southeast Asia, just not here. There are only 2-3 people who are doing it overall. Google, Amazon, and 1 or 2. We need 100. The ecosystem need 100. Lot of opportunities. That's what you give them. It's very true for Malaysia, Singapore, India. 5 seconds. They don't give you second chance. If your product doesn't work, especially digital, they switch. If one shop is shut, you switch, go to the other, right? You don't stand the queue or wait for the whole night to, you know, make it come back. 88%. These are not my numbers. These are all research published numbers. It's about user empathy. So customer expectation is going up, up, up all the way. You know, we all are customers, whether it's digital businesses or the clothes we wear, you know, we expect better, or the bank we go to, or the alcohol what we drink, right? We want something new. Customer centricity is something. I'm telling you, from the background I come, I scored 43-46% in my academics. I've not gone to good school. I'm one of the top 3 paid platform digital people in India. It's only because I represented that customer in that room. CEOs don't like me, but I like that. It's about you. It's always about you. You really don't care whether I solve it for everybody else and I mess up in your order. If you are a vegetarian and I serve you non-veg food, you will kill me, boss. If you don't like, if you're allergic to something or a dairy product and I serve you something, your health goes for a toss. It's about personalization. Whatever business you do, whether it's a physical business, whether it's a repair business, it's a digital platform, it's a bank, it's a hotel, it's anything, it's about that personalization. This is key slide for Nepal. EduTech. So we have Byju's. You don't have a big player. You have food tech, you have one guy. Wallets, you have 2 people. Cab aggregation, you have 2 people. Every category, 3 people can make money. 3 people. It's about local startups. If you don't do it, I'm telling you, somebody will come from outside and do it for you. And he will make money in your market. It's about experience economy. It's about you. It's about you knowing that market more than anybody else. Boss, do I have 1 minute, 1/2 minute, time's up?
1 minute. That means two. You have to make your product from heart, not from mind. Experience is felt from here, not from here. Here you have a logic. You have a formula. Here you have a delight. You know? And it's about everything. Whether what has happened right here in the last 20 minutes or what will happen on the candid conversation on the floor. And this is what you'll get. Companies who have invested in design thinking see 211% more returns. Again, not my number, published number, actual number from big brands. This is about India, but this is true for Nepal also. I have deliberately not made the slide. But I wanted to tell you. So India is 1.3 billion people, and we are on. So we will be 1.35 very soon. So we are 1/5 of world's population. And in totality, there are close to 261 unicorns. So by that logic, I should have close to 52 unicorns in India by now. But we are only half. Only half. And the problem is, most of the startups, they're not profitable. They've raised great rounds, big rounds, unicorns, multi-unicorns. Paisa nahi ban raha. You know, nobody's making money. Only few, only 10% people are making money despite having existed in the ecosystem from last 10 years. So what you can learn from this? I'm coming from India and I'm telling you, learn from something which I've not done it right. 5 P's. Perspective, profit, along with product, process, and people. This is the story. Every happy user, you have a one happy, unhappy user. $50 billion they have to invest back because once you had a bad food, you will not going to come back again. Modest beginnings. I have only 1 minute. And I'll show you. This is, so internet generation is not 10 years, it's only 5 years. Look at it, so it doesn't matter whether you are a number one company in a particular 5 years, it's not necessary that you will go through this change. Everything is available on Google. I don't have any intellectual skill, don't worry. Indigo. We fly 1,400 flights every day with 95% accuracy, on-time accuracy. Mammoth, I'm telling you. Design thinking at a core. So think big. It's only 13 years old company. Indigo is only 13 years old company. InfoEdge Group, they own this. They own Zomato, which is a unicorn. They own Policy Bazaar, which is a unicorn. Diversification. Quicker. So I'm running time, so I'll leave it with this. So how's the future look like? They are with war with everybody. Amazon. What a company. They are selling experience in each and every category. What a thought. But they're having a great leaders. So all the entrepreneurs sitting here, hire smart people, empower them, and make them go rich, make money with you. Don't treat them like an employee. Come on. If you are getting rich, they should also get rich. People buy from the brands they trust, and that's going to be core because you can't buy loyalty of the customers. You have to build traction. You have to innovate. I'll take only, no, he's not. So I'll take questions offline.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Really appreciate it. Thank you.